Hey guys, have you ever wanted to cook a pork butt in your crock pot, but you didn't want to use all that liquid like soda and beer and such, more like braising it than cooking it? Then stick around and I'm going to show you just how to do that. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Bad Beast Barbecue. Hey, there's no denying that our most popular video on our channel is our crock pot pulled pork video that we did several years ago. It's a fantastic recipe, but it uses Coca-Cola and other liquids to kind of braise the pork butt in the crock pot instead of just cooking it, okay? And while that video has gotten a lot of fantastic comments over the years, we've had some people ask for a recipe where you don't use Coca-Cola or beer or what have you, just straight up pork butt, okay? And that's what we're going to do today. So let's get started. All right, guys, so here we have a 7-pound Hormel bone-in pork butt, okay? And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be seasoning it with some Blue Hogs dry rub seasoning. All right, so you can use whatever rub that you want to use, or if you don't have any particular rub, you can make a combination of SPG, salt, pepper, and garlic powder, and I'll put that recipe for the SPG down the bottom, but it's just equal parts of each in a shaker jar, and that'll give you some fantastic flavor. You might even throw this, consider throwing in a little brown sugar in it also to give you some sweetness and some savoriness. We're gonna be going with this Blue's Hogs rub today, all right? So now the key to this is keeping the pork butt out of its own juices, right? Because you don't want to pour any liquid in there, and this, the fat and the rendering of this pork butt in the crock pot is going to produce its own juices. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be using this oval silicone roast rack to go down in the bottom of the crock pot. I'll put the link to this in the description box down below if you're interested, okay? If you don't have one of these or you don't want one of these, then you can take foil and make 5 or 6 1.5-inch foil balls and put down in the bottom of your crock pot. That will elevate the pork butt above any of the juices that it will produce, okay? So hey, let's go ahead and get this bad boy seasoned. Let's go ahead and get the racks in the crock pot and let's get this bad boy underway. We're going to be cooking this thing for 8 hours on high, and then we'll come back and check the temperature of it, okay? We're also going to use a Maverick Ready Check for the entire cook, because I'm gonna let this bad boy cook in here until it reaches 200 degrees temperature, okay? Now, you also always have to be careful not to pinch or crimp the cable for your Maverick Ready Check for the probe, but luckily this crock pot here has a rubber seal around the lid, so when I lock it down, it shouldn't crimp, tear, or damage the probe cable, okay? So, hey, let's get this prep work going. All right, so we're not using any binder because I don't want any oil or any mustard or anything inside of the crock pot, because unlike cooking on a smoker, I don't know if the mustard will evaporate, and so it may liquefy inside of the crock pot and add a flavor that I don't want, okay? So we'll go ahead and we're going to liberally coat. Ooh, a little too much. Got to control that on high. And we have already trimmed this pork butt. We cut as much of the fat off as we can. Normally, if I'm cooking on a smoker, I leave the fat cap on to protect the pork butt during the cook, but since we're in a crock pot, the fire and the heat is much different, so you want to remove as much of the fat as you can. All right, we got it well coated, so let's go ahead and get our crock pot prepped. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put our silicone rack in the bottom. Okay, and we're going to add our pork butt right on top. Turn my probe down to make sure it doesn't get damaged. Put the top on. Now my particular crock pot locks and seals, and I'm gonna use that feature to make sure that the heat stays in and stays constant. And that's it. So all you're gonna do is turn your crock pot on, whatever crock pot that you have, on high for approximately 8 to 10 hours, or until your temperature gauge, if you have one of these, reads 200 degrees. So hey, we'll have the true time at the end and we'll come back for the taste test. So hey, hang around, don't go nowhere. All right guys, so we're back. It's been almost 8 hours. We put the pork butt in our crock pot at 8 o'clock this morning. It is now 2:45, so roughly 8 hours has gone by. Our internal temperature, we came down when it hit 199 degrees, and currently our internal temperature is 203, so we're right on time. We're about to pull this out and we'll see what we have, okay? So the first thing we're gonna do is unlock our crock pot, remove the lid. Smells fantastic. Now I'm gonna give you a look inside of here so you can see exactly how much liquid was produced from a 7-pound pork butt, okay? So as you can see, the liquid is just about at the height, or right above the height of the oval silicone rack we put down in the bottom of it. So if you want to, you can do the foil balls or get you a little bit of higher rack, but it's just barely the base of the pork butt is sitting down inside of its own juices. So, all right, let's go ahead and get this bad boy out, get it shredded, and have a taste test. So I have two forks here in case you don't have the bear claws. I do have a pair of bear claws for pulling apart a pork butt, but we're gonna use regular household forks this time, just for those of you who don't have any bear claws, okay? So we're gonna remove our probe, and we're gonna see just how easy we can get this out of here. All right, so we got it on here, and we're gonna start pulling this apart. Well, let's see if we can get this bone out. If the bone comes out nice and clean, you know it's done. And here's our bone, nice and clean. All right. So let's see if we can get this shredded up a little bit. And using these forks is a little bit harder than I thought. So let me go ahead and get this shredded up right quick. We'll come back for a taste test and I'll let you know how tender it is and what it tastes like and if I recommend doing this for the long haul, okay? So be right back. All right guys, so we're finished shredding up our pork butt. You saw us take the bone out. The bone came out clean and there was a big piece of fat right in the middle of it that hadn't rendered all the way. And that's the thing about cooking a pork butt in a crock pot is that the fat doesn't render the same as it does when it's on a grill or a smoker, okay? So, but we did get it shredded and get most of the meat off of it, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and have a taste test. As you can see, normal pulled pork shredded here. And we're gonna hit it with a little extra Blues Hog seasoning like we always do. And then what we would do is hit it with some sauce, but we're not gonna hit it with some sauce just yet, okay? Now the one thing I do have to say, the difference between this recipe and the recipe we did 4 years ago where we put the Coca-Cola in here is that the Coca-Cola did help tenderize the pork butt throughout the entire cook. So when we lifted it up out of that crock pot on the original recipe, the pork butt just literally fell apart. You didn't have to struggle to shred it or anything. This one here was a little bit tighter because we didn't use any liquid in it, okay? So we pulled this thing out when it was at 203 degrees. Might want to let it go a little bit more, 210, 215. It won't hurt it while it's in this crock pot because you don't have any excessive fire in there, okay? So it's just continuing to break down the tissue, okay? So let's go ahead and have a taste test. smells fantastic though. Yeah. Now this one is more along the lines of traditional pulled pork, where it's not saturated with liquid as the first recipe as we did, okay? So it's have that little bit drier content to it, but it tastes fantastic. Love the Blue Hog's dry seasoning rub. That tastes fantastic also. All this needs is a hit of some type of barbecue sauce or some type of glaze mixed up together, and it'll be fantastic, okay? So we did have quite a lot of fat left off of it that we couldn't render down, but needless to say, plenty of pulled pork for a 7-pound pork butt, okay? Well, that's all we have time for tonight. I hope you like this video, and I hope you like the channel. If you're not a subscriber, please consider subscribing and then hit the bell notification so that you'll know every time that we put out a new video, okay? So this is Crock-Pot 2.0. We'll be putting this out real soon, and like I say, if you have any comments, please put them down in the description block. Until then, like we always say, where there's smoke, there's fire. If it's fire, then damn it, there just might be a barbecue there. Hey, as always, hey, we'll see you guys around the smoker.